One year ago, I decided to build a big ass 15x10 RGB LED matrix. It took a lot of time, but as you can see, this 1.5 meter by 1 meter LED matrix works quite well nowadays. But having just the matrix is a bit useless. So I also built a frame around it with a nice shelf which lights up, and I can change the color or animation with the press of a button and dim the LEDs with a potentiometer. This way it became my LED bar, to serve drinks or just to put stuff on. And it looks way better than I expected in the beginning. That is why I will show you now how I constructed the frame for the matrix and the whole LED bar itself, including the electronics to control the shelter lights. Let's get started. Everything is built around this 1.5 meter by 1 meter square of acrylic glass. And we made sure that it has a milky white color so that light can easily shine through and get diffused at the same time. Firstly, we sawed wooden panels with a width of 12 centimeters into 4 smaller pieces with the help of a jigsaw. And we used sanding paper to smooth the edges afterwards. Those 4 pieces should later form the square for the acrylic glass. So we used a bracket to get a nice 90 degree angle between 2 panels and used a DeWalt drill to pre-drill 2 holes in each intersection. Then everything got secured with big wood screws afterwards. And the main frame is done. Time for the most satisfying part, by peeling off the protective film of one side of the acrylic glass. We positioned the glass on top of the wooden frame and did some basic measurements and marked where to insert 3 wood screws on each frame side. Now, here's an advice when you drill acrylic glass. Take your time. You can't just put screws in there without pre-drilling a hole. And we also used a bigger drill to create an indentation so that the wood screws will later be flush with the glass. And the matrix frame is done. The rest of the bar is mainly built with those long laths. We started to saw 2 of those to a length of 1.495 meter. And also 2 smaller ones to complete a square, which will be positioned underneath the top shelf, which is also a piece of acrylic glass, with a width of 25.5 centimeters. Again, we used wood screws to build the square and also tested out how well the light would shine through this glass, and it looked pretty neat. The dirt was just on the protective film, by the way. Then we went ahead and cut the glass so that it fits on the wooden frame. And the top is done. Now we used this top wooden square and built 2 more wooden squares around it and used smaller pieces of wood to connect them together. Basically, it's all just wooden squares. It's a bit hard to explain, but here's the result, which should give you a good idea of what I mean. As you can see, we also used those big wooden panels for the sides. We cut those with the jigsaw and mounted them again with wood screws. And I used white paint to give the LED bar a nice color. Now let's talk about the lighting system. This time I used a WS2812B LED strip, which has more LEDs per meter as the WS2801 LED strip, which you know from my ambient lighting video. It also only needs 1 pin of the microcontroller to control it, which is neat. I chose the ADTiny 85 to keep everything small and cheap. Here is the schematic. We got 1 push button with pull-down resistor to select the mode, and 1 10 kilo ohm potentiometer to set the brightness. The potentiometer, LED strip and 5 volt power will be connected to the PCB with those terminals. The building of the whole PCB only took me 15 minutes, and I even made a board layout diagram for you guys. So it should be a really easy build. As always, you can download the schematic, code and find a part list on my Instructables site. Link is in the description. And don't forget to program the ADTiny 85 with your programming shield, which I showed you in another video. And you also need the fast LED library, so download it. Now it is time to mount the LED strip underneath the acrylic glass. And if you think, why is the glass suddenly glued to the frame? Well, it was the first try and I removed it later, but more about it in the second part. The first test with the strip was successful. So we decided to fuse the matrix with the bar by pushing it slowly and carefully inside our wooden frame. but it didn't look so great. So we pulled off the protective film on this side and built kind of like a picture frame around it. Again, we used small wooden laths, which are already painted white. And I think it looks way better than before, because you cannot see the transition between the matrix and the bar anymore. And it also hides the big screws in the acrylic glass. Now it is time to score the PCB and break off the unnecessary part. Then I soldered 3 wires to the LED strip, which later connect to the main PCB. Afterwards, I got myself a 5V 3A power supply, which will be enough juice to power the strip. I cut off the old plug and removed the isolation of the positive power wire. And I also double checked the polarity of the wires with my multimeter. Here you can see how I hot glued the PCB to one of the wooden walls, which was a good idea, because it is not too noticeable there. But not a good idea was to glue the potentiometer and the power switch to this wooden side as well, because that was just stupid. I will need to reposition them in the second part. Moving on to the top acrylic glass part, which I already removed once. I just used one small line of acrylic on the frame to glue the glass to it, but silicone would have also worked fine. Then, with a steady hand and a bit of precision, we lowered the glass onto the frame and pressed it in place. Now the lighting effect does look way better than before, because I didn't use so much acrylic which squashed out of the side like last time. With that being said, let's end the first part here, and find out how I completed this build in the next video. As always, thanks for watching, don't forget to like, share, subscribe for more electronics projects, stay creative, and I will see you next time!